Thank you so much. It's a total honor to be here in this fantastic building. And yeah, I just want to do a deconstruction with you today. We're going to be doing Massive Attack Unfinished Sympathy. Does everyone know the track? Okay, well, for those that don't, I'm going to play the track to you, and then we'll just talk a little bit about so, you know, some of the things that went into it, the producers and the players and that kind of thing. So let's remind ourselves of the track, and this is from Top of the Pops. Anyone from the UK will know Top of the Pops. Sadly, no longer with us, but here we go. Here is the track. So there you go. Round of applause for Unfinished Sympathy. What a tune. So a few fun facts. Always good to do a few fun facts. Produced by Massive Attack and Johnny Dollar, who sadly is no longer with us. The original members for this were 3D, Daddy G and Mushroom. Fantastic vocals by Shara Nelson. Also a great string orchestration by Will Malone. And it was from their seminal debut LP, Blue Lines, and it was the second single from that. And it came out on the 11th of February, 1991, which makes it 26 years ago, which is seems like only yesterday. It came out on Wild Bunch through Virgin, and it was recorded at the Coach House in Bristol, and the strings were recorded at Abbey Road Studios, the famous Abbey Road Studios, and was mixed at Matrix Studios in London. The style, I mean, it was around the time of that Bristol scene. Obviously, these guys are from Bristol. And, you know, it's kind of trip-hop. It came before bands like Portishead, that whole kind of scene. Kind of ahead of its time, really. And just production-wise, what's kind of amazing about it is there's no actual bass line. The bass is provided by the string orchestration. So, yeah, the title is a pun on Schubert's Unfinished Symphony. Or Symphony No. 8 in B minor. Should we quick listen to that? Doesn't really bear much relation. Enough of that. There's obviously strings, so that's something that's got in common. So yeah, talking about the strings, they were originally played on a synth, but Johnny Dollar suggested using an orchestra. Which obviously everyone jumped at, they thought, brilliant. But it made them go way over budget, and apparently, I don't know where I got this from, but they ended up selling their car, which is a Mitsubishi Shogun. So that was obviously very sad. So there's some samples, and I've actually got these records, which are pretty amazing. The first that I would recommend, actually, the website whosample.com, because pretty much any track you can find out what the original samples are from. That's certainly where I got this information from. So yeah, the first one is from this album called Willie Dynamite. It's a soundtrack. J.J. Johnson Parade Strut Instrumental, 1974. Let's have a listen to that. There you go, there's the beat. Now, this one's an interesting one because it was up until the point where I actually started researching this, I thought that the vocal was Shara Nelson, this little vocal sample. Turns out it's not. It's from this album, Mahavishnu Orchestra and John McLaughlin, Planetary Citizen, from the album Inner Worlds, and from 1976. So let's check this out. Oh, and I've got this as well, album. Here we go. One another, we can open doors. Hey, hey. check out this break. I mean, there's a loop. There you go. I mean, it sounds amazing. Maybe I'll just sample that and just do something completely different. Okay, so the other significant thing about this track is this sort of bell riff. And what they were actually trying to emulate was this track by Bob James, Take Me to the Mardi Gras. Emulate, I think that's the right word. Anyway, let's have a listen to that and you'll hopefully see the similarity. Pretty tight, love that. In actual fact, the bell sound that they used was from a Roland R8 drum machine. And it's the standard factory sound, it's the ring one sound. And it sounds like a toy piano or something. Later on, I'm going to actually try creating our own bell sound, which is why I've got this hotel bell here. So we'll have a look at that. So just a quick thing about the deconstruction. I've been doing these deconstructions for quite a while now, and essentially, it's where we take apart the elements of a track to understand them. And we use it as an educational tool at Point Blank, which is where I work, to teach music theory and production techniques. And the first course that I wrote for them was called EMC, Electronic Music Composition. And the idea is just to, there may be some people that might have not had or been lucky enough to have a music education or to learn piano, and they get to a point with their productions when they just they feel like they need to kind of take it a bit further. So I try to teach, we try to teach some music theory, but just in a context of electronic music or really well-known tracks. So, and obviously I try to put in my hero Herbie Hancock into pretty much every page, just to illustrate his keyboard techniques. And yeah, you can find this on our degree, the Aeons degree. So there we go. Now, one final note is that the reason I originally did this deconstruction was for one of our modules on the BA, which is our advanced recording and mixing module, where the students have to record a string ensemble. And I thought, well, I should kind of create a cool track for them to actually, for us to get a string arrangement and then actually record them. So I'm not going to be using their session in the deconstruction, but here's some footage of the actual session. And we collaborate with music, the students from the Royal Academy of Music. So it's great, they can come, they can get experience in the recording situation, that kind of pressure situation, and our students benefit from that as well. So here's some footage of them recording. There you go. A round of applause for students from the Royal Academy of Music. Right, so let's try to recreate this track. Bear with me, I might make a few mistakes. There's a lot going on here. I've got a turntable, I'm going to try sampling, I've got keyboards, so let's go for it. Right, we're going to start off with a kick drum. This is an 808, the standard kind of kit. And yeah, let's put the metronome on. I'm actually going to put this in step time. Maybe get the right sound, that might help. Amazing. Right, this by the way, I'm on live 10 here. I don't know if anyone noticed. It's pretty cool. So it means we've got some visualization on push, which is great. So I've got the clip view here. So I can actually lower the velocity of this preceding kick here. So we've got the first bit. Now, I mentioned earlier they had they were using a Roland R8 drum machine. So I've got that here. So I'm not sure if they actually use these drum sounds, but I think these will do. So I'm just going to put the repeat function on here. So let's record that in. Cool. So there we go. We've got our first scene. Fantastic. So I'm now going to click on duplicate to create another scene. And we're going to put the snare in. I'm just going to put this in just with a step sequencer. Cool. So there we go. Thanks a lot. See you later. Right. Let's go for the next thing. Now, this is the break. This is the parade strut break. And I'm going to actually record this in from vinyl. I'm going to use a range view because there's a little bit of manipulation I want to do for this. So let's just see if we've got a signal. Okay, let's take it back. Go. We got it in. Amazing. So let's have a listen to that coming back and let's just check it out. Turn up a little bit. So looking at that, there are two potential sections of that. What I'm looking for is a one bar loop to loop this up. So if we go to this first section here, now that could be a loop. That could be as well. And if you can hear, it sounds like there's a tambourine going along with it, and it's quite scrappy in this first section. Whereas it's much tighter in that section. So I think I'm going to have to work with kind of both of those and maybe combine them together. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is right-click, you know the drill, set 1.1 there, and then just take the start point there. There we go. So I'm going to add some warp markers in, just so we get it all tightened up. Let's just put the metronome on. Together. Here we go. So let's just do that. We can take off that metronome. Although I do like that metronome, I have to say it's the new wood sound. Don't know if anyone's checked that out. Like a good wood sound. Okay. So what I'm going to do is just take this section here, and I'm just going to copy that over. There we go. And let's have a listen to that. Okay, let's just loop that. I think that's sounding pretty good. So, I'm going to consolidate that. Command J, we all know that. Key command, I hope. And we're going to put that in there. And let's just have another look at it now and just see if we can do any more tightening up warping wise. I can just see that those transients aren't totally matching up with the grid. Let's just play that now. I'm just going to solo it actually. There we go. Might help if I looped it. Appropriate for this event. Cool. So let's play it with the kick and the snare and the hi-hat that we had. Nice. So I think it's processing time. I'm going to, I don't know if you can hear it on the speakers, but it's a very wide stereo image. The tambourine's kind of way off on one side. So let's mono it up. Let's get the utility involved. So this is the nice new utility device in Live 10. So let's decrease the width. Maybe not so extreme, but I think that's probably cool. Go for some EQ. Let's just maybe take off a bit of the bottom end, so to make sure it's going to fit in with the kick and the snare. And increase around there, maybe around 2K. Okay, sounding pretty good. So, the next thing. Now, I mentioned that sample before, but we're going to do it ourselves. We're going to get our own sample together, for which I bought this. It's a hotel bell. It was sitting in my parents' kitchen for about 20 years. Always found it quite annoying until I came to do this deconstruction, and I thought, well, it could come in handy. So I'm going to sample this. Hopefully this is working. Let's just see if I've got a level. There we go. So let's just put that in. Let's do a couple. There we go. And we got it in. Amazing. Okay, so let's try to put this onto push into simpler. So I'm going to hit convert, press simpler, and first thing I'm going to do is. Oh, it's actually come out pretty well. Okay, so let's zoom in a little bit more so we can get a good start point. There we go. That's quite happy with that. I think that's pretty good. So yeah, let's take the loop off, and let's also turn warping off as well. What else? Let's increase the release. Let's make it monophonic, so make sure it's just one voice. And also, we could do a bit of filtering as well. I used to use the bandpass. I think that's pretty good. Let's increase the gain a bit. Okay. Okay, it's getting there. Let's try compressing it. Just going to take the threshold down. There we go. So let's just mute the original sample. Cool, let's put it in. I suppose we could sweeten up a little bit, maybe put a bit of reverb on it. Why not? Beautiful. Put the level up a little bit. Okay, so now, because we're working on our second scene, and I want to kind of keep in this session view here so we can build up all the different sections of the track. So this is our sort of basic, these are our basic parts. So I'm going to duplicate this six times, and then we can start adding things to that section. And the next thing I'm going to add is the Planetary Citizen sample. So it's sampling time again. Bear with me. Here we go. Mahavishnu Orchestra, John McLaughlin. Track three. Let's put it into record. Here we go. Okay, so let's find this bit. Make sure that's down.
When we love one another, we can open doors. Hey, hey, hey.
Hooray. Oops, dear, sorry. Got it from Discogs, by the way. It wasn't cheap as well. So I better look after it. Not that I'm going to resell it or anything after this. So yeah, we've got that. Let's hit convert. Let's put it into simpler again. And we love one another. We can open. We can open. Whoa, that's pretty lucky. That's pretty good. Okay, so let's just do a bit of processing on that. Let's take loop off again. And we want to take warping off again. We want to increase the release. Now, one thing about this sample, it's got a really annoying snare at the end of it. Can you hear that? So what I want to try to do is, when I play this in, try to just have that so it's tailing off, so we kind of miss as much of that snare. We can roll off some bottom end as well, though that will help. So that sort of thing. So hopefully it will get a bit buried, so we won't have to worry about it too much. So yeah, let's do some filtering. Let's put some high pass filter on this. And let's also put some reverb on it, because it's certainly heavily reverbed on the original track. There we go, maybe a little bit too much. Okay. We love one another, we let's get rid of the original one. There we go, zero. And this is actually playing semitone down. So let's just play this over the top and see what it sounds like. Cool, let's put it in. I reckon we can just give it a little bit more. Even if we do hear a bit of that snare, I think that's pretty cool. Nice. So that's the sampling done. Fantastic. We can all relax now. Well, I can relax a little bit. Okay, now let's look at the string part. That's the next part to look at. And hopefully my keyboard's working. Yes, it is. Right, it's music theory time. I hope you're all up for some music theory. So here we go. Key signature. Anyone know what? Well, it's written down so you can see it. It's D minor. Anyone know what the relative major of D minor is? Ah, oh, fantastic. There we go. And it's got one flat in it. It's B flat here. F major, D minor. And what's really nice about this is that all the chords only use notes from the scale of D natural minor. What I'm doing here is playing triads on the degrees of the scale. So this would be the one chord, this would be the four chord, this is the five chord, three of the most famous chords in the world ever. So this makes it kind of quite easy for us. So let's play some strings. Here we go. Now, in order for us to be able to see everything that's being played, I'm just going to change the bass octave. No, wrong direction. Oops, let's do it to four. There we go, that's exactly what I wanted to do. So yeah, take the notes off. All right, just a quick side note. This is one of Ableton's factory packs. It's the string ensemble, and I love it, it's great. So, very nice. Let's put the first string bit part in, which is the intro. Let's just bring up the preview. So this is very, very simple. It's just an open fifth on the D down here. Really nice. Anyone doesn't know, this is the interval 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's why it's called a fifth. So let's record that in. Okay, so let's put the next section, and I've called it the hey, hey section, and let's get it onto the right sound. Here we go. So that's beautiful. That the chords there are, I'm playing an F triad over D. Essentially, that's D minor 7, just not playing that D. And then it goes up to an F. And then this chord here, which is a G sus 2. So standard triad is the 1, 3, and 5. Sus 2, instead of playing the third note, you're playing the second one. It's kind of, it's almost like it's sort of non-committal. You know, if it was this, you feel like it's bold, it's making a statement, whereas this is a little bit more ambiguous. So let's put that in. Making progress, I think. So right, now we get into the verse section, and this is where it really opens up. I keep forgetting to do this. Anyway, note. So for these chords, we go for a B flat over G, essentially a G minor 7. Then it goes to the 5 chord, A minor 7. Back to the 1 chord again. This is my chord of the year. Beautiful. Now that is a, how I'd define that. I know that Logic has got a kind of chord thing. It tells you what chord you're playing. Never want to use Logic, stick with Ableton. This is this is a G diminished seventh, but without the third note, with a B flat and a bass. And obviously it wants to resolve, and it wants to resolve to the 5 chord, which is the A minor 7. And that's weirdly without the third note, the C. Except it doesn't go to the major. So let's put that in and see if I can remember it. Go. Well, okay. So let me just play. And then that goes nicely back to. Cool. So we are making more progress now. This is exciting. So that was the first verse, and I'm going to copy that down to the next scene because there is a second verse, amazingly. Now, there's also a middle section, and a middle section is very similar to the verse section. Bring up the chords again. There we go. Except the third chord is a G minor 7. Over the B flat. So the only difference is it's not that, it's a bit more definitive. So let's put that in. Oh yeah, there's an extra bar at the end as well. Okay, we are so nearly there. There's just one section, which is the outro section now, which is essentially the hey hey section with a bit more movement in the bass. There was that other stuff that I showed you earlier, the Royal Academy of Music, who's doing all sorts of things. We're going to be here all day if I do that. So let's just do this one. Sort of improvising there. I don't know if that is exactly what they played, but who cares? So, right, it's a cappella time. I was able to enlist a good friend of mine by the name of Valerie Etienne. You may know her from bands such as Galliano. And she came in and did the vocal, which is great. So I'm going to put that in, and we're going to play it along with the stuff that I've put in. So I'm just going to drag these over in pure Blue Peter fashion, something I've prepared earlier. Here we go. So we've got all our sections there. Now, let's get rid of the keyboard, and let's have a listen to Valerie's vocal.
I know that I've imagined love before, and how we could be with you. Really hurt me, baby, really cut me, baby. How can you have a day without a night? You're the book that I have opened, and now I've got to know much more.
Round of applause. I think before I play through the whole track, which is normally how these deconstructions finish, I'm going to put in a little piano part, a little jazzy piano part, which I love. That part there. So let's just put that in. And that will be the last bit of recording, sadly. Oh man, first mistake. Let's go again. Wow, okay. So, it keeps, after every section, after every verse, every middle section, it always comes back to the hey hey section. So in order for me to be able to switch back to that section and the vocal to carry over, we're going to utilize one of Ableton's amazing remove stop button features. There we go. So we've got that in. So should we have a listen to the track all the way through? Yes? Okay, here we go. Here is my version of Unfinished Sympathy.
Curiousness of your potential kiss has got my mind and body aching. Really hurt me, baby. Really cut me, baby. How can you have a day without a night? You're the book that I have opened, and now I've got to know much more.
section.
Like a soul without a mind, in a body without a heart, I'm missing every part. Hey, yeah, hey, yeah, hey, yeah.
Piano bit. Outro.
Like a soul without a mind, in a body without a heart, I'm missing every part. Like a soul without a mind, in a body without a heart, I'm missing every part.
Let's just remind ourselves.
Like a soul without a mind, in a body without a heart, I'm missing every part.
There we go. Thank you very much.